all, thank you very much for having me here. I never knew that I did all that, whatever I just saw. So we have close to 19 minutes, 2 seconds. So pardon me for that intro, which was longer than what I was expecting. How many of you are from HR fraternity here? I'm sure both of you will like this presentation. How many of you are not from HR fraternity? You will like more. Okay, so the advantage of doing presentation after lunch or maybe after 2 or 3 sessions is that most of the things that you want to talk is already been spoken. But luckily, I was just watching all these presentations. Let me be honest with you. Only 5% is overlap. So if you are sleeping now, you will miss what? 95%. If you are sleeping earlier also, you would have missed the 5% also. Right? Are people most important asset? Yes, no? How many of you say yes? I have a slight different opinion. I say right people. Okay, and now you ask me who are right people, then we can go up to the next 2 hours to discuss about what is that, right? So my topic was very clear. How do we reimagine HR, right? So a lot of placement officers are here. They would think they are already working with HR people to kind of get their students placed and all that. So to give a look at what HR is all about, the traditional ribbon that you see on top is your talent acquisition, business partnering, compensation benefit, learning and development, and HR operations. With the advent of AI and a lot of these new generation technologies which Nagin Garwan, you know, these people talked about, a lot of importance come into HR analytics. We're talking about experience enabling teams, right? I was told recently that companies are adopting a new culture of having experience managers into their system. What does it mean? They are truly interested in understanding or enhancing the employee experience and also the candidate experience, right? Benchmarking teams, we always want to be the best. So if you see the bottom ribbon, it is not different than the top ribbon. They are interconnected. If you stay where you are, doing conventionally, I don't think you will exist in the next 5-10 years. This is the message that I am trying to give you. Right? So here I am trying to weave three, four different points. We saw Industrial Revolution 1, 2, 3, 4, right? I think my friend was talking about Industry 4.0, right? Now, if you really see the way HR has evolved, we started off as welfare officer. How many of you have heard this word terminology called welfare officer? Very good. Slowly we became personal managers. Sir, you would have seen this thing, right? Human resource manager. Now the twist is human resource manager with an AI. Sir was talking about one of the concept of you will not lose job. Answer is yes. The context is if you don't adopt to AI, those guys who would adopt to AI will actually make you replaced. What I'm trying to say? People who adopt to AI will replace those people who don't adopt to AI, right? Okay, what's changing? How many of you heard this terminology called chatbots? What do they do, ma'am? What do they do? Communicate. Can't we communicate? Are we saying that they are better communicators? I think one of the important points which was, you know, talked about earlier was those tasks will be replaced. There are certain tasks which are actually repeatable, can be replaced. With the advent of technology, chatbots are coming into picture. Now there is a lot of efficiency coming in, but there is a lot of focus on effectiveness. How are we actually delivering it? If you say that 75 people have come for an interview, 3 of them have got a job, it's a good metric to have, but if you really see, 72 people have not got a job and they may not have a good experience. Even though they did not get a job, can they get good experience at least? Yeah? Talent branding. Companies used to talk about, we are doing this, we are doing that and all that. Now you will see, they are putting a poster of a particular employee talking about that employee. Why do they do that? Because employees are their actual assets. We're talking about data gathering. HR is now pushed towards, okay, data is there. How can you predict? With the predictive model, they're asked to see how we are successful, right? We're talking about reward and recognition. Earlier, I remember a scenario where if you are favorite to your boss, you are rewarded. Today, your data has to speak. You cannot be good to your boss and still get recognized. There's a lot of governance, but today, there's a lot of freedom. You would not want to join a company which has so many rules than the company which wants to take you to a place where you can do whatever you want to do. Market intelligence, right? We're talking about gamification. I've heard a terminology where when you go into a company, they will not have 10 slides for onboarding. They will give you a game where you can actually play and learn the entire onboarding process. How cool is that? We're talking about employee benefit programs. So now organizations, what they have done is they have categorized companies, employees into X, Y, Z category, when I say generation, and they are devising those new benefits for those new generation employees, right? Companies have moved from hierarchical to flat organizations. You have seen that happening in most of the product organizations. We were talking about sourcing. Earlier, when a recruiter has to look at 100 resumes, he has to physically look at. Today, we have advent of AI, screening tools, matching tools, which can actually tell you that these are the five required CVs that you can talk about along with the visio kind of thing, which is kind of coming up in terms of, you know, video resume. Chatbots, we talked about it, right? You no longer go and ask or, you know, you can just return to your chatbot and ask, how many leaves do I have? How many of my team members are still, you know, on leave today? Or anything like that. Early talent programs. Earlier, companies used to come at fourth year, first semester. Now companies are actually coming to your campuses at second year, first semester, second year, second semester. Why are they doing that? They want to impart knowledge so that the gap that is there post their training is very minimal or zero, right? Formal process to experience. Experience is taking a larger role than a typical formal process. And HR manager, who used to be earlier called, is called as career manager, right? So with this, I have a small thing. So what really happens is employees are our brand ambassadors. If you treat them as human beings. So here I end. I think 10 minutes, ready for any questions you have. Thank you.